Calm down, dude. Oh my god.
Meow time.
What's going on, guys? I'm here. Welcome back to a brand new video. 100 and welcome back to some more Mario Kart Wii today. We're gonna be using the just painfully average, mediocre vehicle called the Jet Bubble. It's just awful, really. Like, on some of the lightweight characters, you kind of have, like, the tighter drift. I mean, the one thing this vehicle kind of has, you can maybe say that the acceleration, like, right there, it might be a bit higher, but still, that's not too good for a lightweight at all. It's just mediocre at best. I got them both right there. Alright, I do think it's such a shame, though, because I do actually enjoy how this vehicle looks. Just, you know, the aesthetics is pretty dope. Here we go. We're actually keeping up to some extent as well, which is kind of funny too, right? It being a mediocre, average vehicle, getting average results would be quite logical. Here we go. Hopefully the guy gets TC'd before the race ends and I can actually get fourth. Third? I'm not sure what happened there. I'll take it though. But yeah, at least with pretty much every other inside drifting vehicle, they kind of have something going on for it, whether that's like high acceleration, high drift, mini turbo, and then even the spur and the sneaks are high speeds, right? That's all very good, but the Jet Bubble just bad with everything, really. And I mean, when I say average, I literally mean like the most average kind of stats imaginable. Just look at that. Oh, it's just disgusting, though. Nothing else to say about it. It's just, I think the Bowser bike, right, has a tighter drift than this freaking thing. It's actually called Bubble Bike here as well. It might be different on the American version then, because I do believe it's called Jet Bubble. Yeah, it's actually called Jet Bubble on the American version. That makes sense, though. It doesn't make it any better, is the thing. Oh, it's painful. Here we go. We're actually front running. Let's see how much I can actually keep this lead here. Yeah, oh my god, we're actually doing it, dude. We're actually breaking away. Oh no, that's such a bad idea. But if it can work, then I'll definitely take the challenge here, obviously. Oh, I choked so hard right there. That's literally my fault, actually. Yeah, I tried to back some of the green shit, but my finger kind of slipped, so I hit the wall and fell off. It's really, really bad. Well, there goes my front run, I guess. Oh my god, okay. We can maybe get a comeback going on, but on this track, it's definitely a front running track as well, so aren't too many spots to actually get, or to, oh, there aren't too many spots to save time at, sadly, so I'll try my best, but yikes. Oh, that's one way to end a race, I suppose, right there. Probably a lost disconnect as well, losing some VR here too. It's never my connection that fails, it's usually the Wii Fi servers that's bad as well, though. Yeah, I actually don't think the track matters either, man. Like, usually, using, like, underrated and bad vehicles, I try to pick my tracks, so I at least have a little bit of an advantage still. But I mean, it's literally all so terrible. You literally don't excel at anything, and it's really holding you back big, big time. I mean, I would even argue that most cars are better than this vehicle right there, because they have the weight stat, right? They can still snake around, push people off, and get the bikes off their course. Oh my god, someone else disconnected too. Yeah, the servers are so unstable, man. Three-player racer. Yikes. Seems like a third place for me too, unless I can actually beat them, but seeing as it's mirror, I definitely don't think so, but let's see how it goes, though. Outlining him, there you go. Oh my god, I hate 1v1v1s, though. It's the same with 1v1s. You build DCs in third and second. I actually felt that, too. But basically, the person at first just breaks away, and that's about the race, then, so it's definitely not the most fun, but I can definitely try. Oh my god, you just can't turn tight enough, dude. Like, I would almost want to call this, I would almost want to call this a spare of the mini weights. But it's just not good, right? You don't have the extra speed, so you don't have anything. Oh my god, dude, getting gold as a third. That's how you know. That's how you know. Oh, no chance at all. Let's see. Yeah, that was the 5k player. All right, here we go. So, about tracks, I think I figured it out now. So, the tracks you want to pick are the smaller tracks, so you don't have to endure the pain for as long. Oh, there you go. The guy's actually using the spare now, so I can respect that at least, right? At least he has some extra speed there. There's no way I can compete with that with this thing, but we'll see how it goes, though. Maybe with the lines, I can save some time on him. It's a very line-heavy track, obviously. There you go. I'm already winning on time. See? There you go. Now use the bomb too. Remove him. If I lose against a spare player, I'm literally done, man. I'm like, yes, it's a bad vehicle, but like, again, I'd probably say that the spare is better, but oh my gosh. It's just my pride that I want to keep, and I don't want to lose against, like, too many vehicles here. Oh my god, he's actually beating me already. My first lap, that's not cute at all. Oh my god, here we go. Now, you can't pull shocks in a four-player race, of course, so I'm just really, really, like, stuck on these items here, right? The Gordons, the Maybe Bills, that would be good, but it's actually a battle between us as well. That's actually crazy, dude. Oh, I hate this so much. There you go, come on. Wait, second place? What? Did that person disconnect or did I actually beat him? I think I'm actually in second place. That's crazy as well. Okay. Keep it, man. Your lines. Come on. Oh, there you go. Red show. That's fine, actually. That should break right there. Yes, it does. Yeah, it does. Okay. I guess the one advantage you have, and I don't even think it's the thing, but you might have a smaller hitbox as you're a mini weight. But again, just looking at the vehicle itself, it just looks kind of big as well. So I'm not sure how true that actually is. But if it is the case, then that's at least something right there that you have a little advantage in, so that's good. Alright, meanwhile, my lead is actually extending as well. We're doing very good, guys. It's probably the best race you're gonna get from me using this thing for sure. Alright, there you go. I might want to chain this as well. I'm not quite sure about that, because I could get blued right now, but that would be very unlucky. There you go, we're fine. Yeah, there's the blue as well. No, that sucks. I lose my mushroom too. Come on, get it. Oh, that's an awful way to lose your second spot. We had it in the bag, dude. We actually messed up big time right there. That's my fault again. And that's not the first time that's happened too, man. When you're like, get hit before a blue shell, so you can't use your mushroom. You have it ready, right? You know the timing. You've got everything down, but you just physically, you can't use it, so it hurts. Maybe luck tracks are where it's at though, yeah. Like, logically thinking, right? Because on luck tracks, it really doesn't really matter what vehicle you use, usually. As long as you're just in the right spot at the end, so you can, like, do the shortcut. And you can actually get first, or at least the top spot, right? That's the whole goal. Yeah, see, I've got a mushroom here. I want to actually hold this, then, until the last lap, and actually get a good spot, right? That's the whole goal now. Again, I explained it. That should be working out. I'll lose time for the moment, obviously, though. So I gotta watch out that I don't get, like, that I don't get slow-owned by myself, pretty much. If you know what I'm saying, right? That's, oh my god. Okay. Oh, god. There's a person using the shooting star as well. I'm liking this lobby, don't get me wrong, but we gotta get second at least here, man. Don't fail again, hopefully. Oh, it's coming up. Last few turns. Again, we're gonna do the strategy here. Doing the single cut. Oh, you can't even make that, dude. That's crazy. There you go. Will I get third? Okay. I might have used my shroom a bit earlier there as well, but oh, that's not pretty at all, eh? Here we go. Take 3. Again, Lux tracks, man. That's where we gotta rely on now. Please give me second at least. That's all I'm asking for. Oh, I love how the guy with the spear is just casually front running it to you like it's nothing as well. Come on. I wonder how hard the dock is though with this freaking thing. Let's find out actually. Okay, that's not bad. There you go. Bumped him against the wall as well. We're doing very, very solid here. But as you can see on the minimap, the guy in first is way ahead because he did the double cut most likely. And that's what we gotta do as well, last lap, or at least a single. Like, if we're in an okay spot going into the cut, then we can definitely be fine doing a single as well, of course, right? But we gotta do either one for sure. There we go, that's the cut we gotta do. We can actually block it to ourselves. There you go. Okay. That's still good though, right? We made it. Not too bad right there, I'll take it. Yeah, maybe being lighter actually helps with the dock cut as well, because then you can do it far less fast, you have more time to actually make it to the dock. So that could definitely help you, on 100cc especially. Here we go though, finally, second place, right there, with the jet bubble, or the bubble bike, depending on which continent you're watching this from. That is very, very solid right there, I'll take it. For sure. And I do think that's also gonna do it for this video right there. So if you guys enjoyed, then by all means, leave a like down below and subscribe for more videos just like this one on the channel. And click the little cat bell to stay notified on YouTube as well. And then I'll see you guys in the next episode. Enjoy your stay.